Hello everyone, hope you guys are doing good. I'm here with an upcycling project today, and this project is basically made using waste materials, and the waste materials that I'm going to use in this project are waste series. In general, you would use them for some work or something like that, and you would discard it later. So here I have a method to organize all these waste series and make a photo frame out of it. Usually you will have many 4x6 or 5x7 photographs which are not used properly. Only few of them go into album, or you can just make prints out of it and you would just save it, and they would be in cupboard just like that. So here is a way to organize all these things and make a very cute photo frame. This is completely cost effective and this is made up of waste materials. So as I said, we'll just look into the required materials of the project. The required materials are CDs, photographs, glue. I'm using a super glue to, you know, fix the CDs, and a glue to photos. And you require scissors, a pen or pencil to draw an outline. And I'm using a floral cord. I would basically use this to make a cord behind the CDs just to hang it on the wall. And you may require a tissue paper and cotton. I'm using this cotton to wipe the dust present on the CDs. So let's look into the process now. You have to take all these CDs and arrange them in an orderly fashion. And you can take as many as you want depending on the photo frame you want to make. Taking 8 of them, but you can take as many as you want. After arranging, you can just glue them all with super glue. We are done with the frame, and now just give some time for the frame to dry and adjust itself. Now we will just look into the photos part, and this is the part 2 in the process. So what would you do is you can just select a theme to make this photo frame. For instance, here I am just making a frame for those pictures which I took in my Florida trip. Basically, I went to Disneyland and I have got good pics from there. So I just want to make a frame with these pics. So I would just select those pics and I would just cut it in a circular shape. Okay, and the shape must be exactly 1 centimeter less in radius to the CD shape. So for instance, if the CD shape is this much, you must just make a photo of the size, so that you know the rest of the CD would act as a border to the photograph and it would make a frame. You must take a pic and then you must draw a circle behind the pic, and after drawing the circle, just put it in front of a light and you must be able to see the desired picture, you know, within the circle. And you can just cut rest of the photograph. So I'm just cutting this. Have to cut all the pics in circular shape. Once you cut, you must actually put it on the frame and see if they are correctly fitting in the frame or not. In case if they are too large, you can cut it small. In case if it is too small, you can select a new pic and then, you know, cut it in a circular shape. For instance, I have just cut 8 pics because I took 8 CDs, and now I would just put these photos on the frame just to check if they are going well. Just number them in order to, you know, avoid all the confusion. Now we are done with everything. The last step is to fix all these photos on the frame, and we will just apply some glue to the pics and do that. I would just apply some glue behind the pic or the photograph and then paste it on the CD which we are using as a photo frame. We are done with pasting all the photos on the CDs, and now we are just left with a card so that we can hang them on the wall. So this is how it would look once it is done. This is how it would look. For card, I would take a floral tape. You can take any kind of lace if you want, and you can just attach it behind the CDs. But I'm actually using a floral tape, and just take a considerable length of tape, and then you can start to twirl it. I usually use this because this is synthetic, and this is really good in terms of durability. That is one reason I use this floral tape, and I can make a card easily with that. You can just see it here, and I can stretch it easily. We are actually done with the card, and I would paste the card over here just to restore the center of balance of the whole frame. So I would just paste it here, and I would just use the super glue again. Final product. Because of the light, I think this is looking a bit glary, but when I hang it on the wall in a soft white light or any kind of tube light, it would really look good, and we will not find all this glare, and the project is complete. I would just hang it on the wall and then show you how it looks. This is how it would look after hanging it on a wall. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and liked it. So, in case if you just like my videos, you can just subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video.